a Dirty Weekend. We're a live network's only festival-themed band.
The concept of the band is to bring the spirit and the fun and, of course, the bands from real festivals to your event. Got a devil's hair truck in my mind.
So we've been doing weddings for a long time, and one of the things that consistently came back from all of our clients was that they wanted to customise their event to reflect the music that them and their mates listen to, which is great. So we had this idea to build the festival sets. It's really simple. You choose the festival set that reflects the music that you and your mates listen to.
We also see a lot of festival-themed weddings and band-themed tables at weddings.
Like the Snow Patrol table.
Yeah, or the Blur table.
The Oasis table.
Yeah. So we thought it would be a good idea.
Yeah, they go hand in hand, really, don't they?
To mix the two. Classic festivals and classic weddings. Of sets, and each one is themed on a different classic festival experience.
So of our different festival sets, you pick your favourite three. So for example, you might pick V Festival if you're really into pop and a bit of indie. You might pick Reading and Leeds if you really like sort of 90s rock. You might pick Live Aid 1985 if you really love George Michael and synth pop and all of the guys who played at that festival. 80s, exactly.
Yeah.
Lots of keyboards.
Go to a festival, you notice that the bands are structured so that you really get more of a buzz as the day goes on, and it builds to a headliner. So that's what we've tried to encapsulate with the way we structure our sets.
So it starts off and it just builds and builds and builds to a massive crescendo, and we always have the biggest artists and biggest tracks as a headliner to each set. Thanks for watching. We've been Dirty Weekend, and we'll leave you with our performance of Franz Ferdinand from the Reading and Leeds set. I said